Hey there, it's Jenny Holbert, and you're listening to the Wild Wellness Podcast. I'm so grateful that you're tuning in because today I'm sharing my current recipe for confidence. So, do you ever look at other people who seem to have it all together and always seem so confident and wonder, what do they have that I don't? I know it often seems that way when we look at other people, but the truth is, nobody feels confident all the time. Every human deals with self-doubt, insecurities, difficult decisions. And the thing is, we all have to manage the inner critic. So we all deal with that voice that questions whether or not we have what it takes, whether or not we're enough. So I think it's important to call this out because if you're comparing yourself to other people constantly, you're just going to feel worse. And the reason I know all this is true is because I'm speaking from experience. Number one, I feel fear and self-doubt on a regular basis, like probably daily. And I have to pay attention to that inner critic voice that I have too. So I know when I started my business, for example, there were so many things that I didn't know, so many questions that I had about my abilities and whether or not I could do this. I also remember in college when I studied abroad in Spain, when I hardly knew Spanish, that was a moment of feeling really doubtful of what that was going to look like and how I was going to make it through. But what I want to share is that self-confidence comes from a few things. And one of them is knowing your strengths and abilities and taking action, which requires more courage than confidence, at least in the beginning, because courage will help you take action, which usually helps you to get better at whatever it is you're doing, which then will make you more confident. So I was thinking about this whole confidence thing recently, and I realized that something I've been doing recently is something I learned way back when I was getting my degrees in exercise science and doing my graduate work in sports psychology. I actually studied this concept called self-efficacy, which is our belief in our ability to do something. So I happen to be studying self-efficacy in relationship to exercise and our ability to get out there and do it, motivation related, but the same principles with self-efficacy apply to feeling confident in other areas of our life as well. So here it is. Part of feeling confident is about reflecting on past wins and successes. So the research shows that when you recognize the fact that you did something amazing, no matter how small or how big, it can affirm your own confidence, which gives you the motivation to move forward and take the next step. So are you one of those people who shies away from sharing your wins or being recognized for a success? Maybe this idea of reflecting on past wins and successes doesn't feel that comfortable to you. Maybe you've been taught to just kind of keep quiet about those things. You know, I get it because you may have grown up being told not to brag, and it often can feel similar to that. You may have gotten the message to not stand out too much. But the thing is, when we continue to do that, we block the joy that we can get from an accomplishment and something that we can be really proud of. So before I go any further, I want to share that the reason that this has come up for me recently is because I had gone through some challenges with my business in the last couple years. And a while back when I was feeling discouraged, I heard that inner wise woman remind me of a success that I had experienced in many different areas. And then that's when I remembered how important it is to reflect on past wins to feel more confident in moving forward. Because when you're in that place, when you're feeling discouraged, that's the moment that you need it. You know, if we're honest with ourselves, if we feel knocked down, sometimes our confidence wanes. So I thought about the wins that I did have, how I had done certain things successfully before, how I had felt really good in those times. And honestly, I thought to myself, if I did it then, I can do it now. If that happened at one point, it can happen again. And I realized the same thing a few months ago with running. I was actually doing hill repeats and had been feeling pretty low and in a slump with training for my upcoming race. And I was actually talking it out with my husband that time, and he reminded me how I had done the 47-mile rim-to-rim-to-rim in the Grand Canyon. We had done it together in 14 hours. And that was something, honestly, that I went into with very little backing to feel confident in a sense, meaning that I felt like I just did it. I didn't have anything from past experience that was exactly the same telling me that it would go well or I could do it. I hadn't done anything like that before. But the fact that I had done other things that maybe were similar, and the fact that I did that at that time, now I have that to pull from. And it gives me confidence to go out there and experience other things now. And I know it was a huge part of me recently doing a race where I ran about 30 miles. I've done a few marathons since that 47-mile rim-to-rim-to-rim, but no ultra distances. And that was the first time since. So I thought back and I focused on those amazing experiences that I had had and I felt proud of from the past, things that I was amazed that my body was able to carry me through. And it really works. You know, we have to focus on even the smallest wins. We have to look at them, sometimes write them down, maybe journal about it or post it somewhere that you're going to see it. Maybe it's even a picture of something that you've done in the past so you have that visual. That is really powerful. It doesn't matter what resonates with you or how you decide to do it. Maybe it's even a background on your phone. It just matters that you do it. Celebrate the things that you feel proud of. There's just something extremely motivating about seeing progress on paper, and this is why a training journal is valuable too. So I highly recommend you start one if you don't already. Track your workouts and things that you're doing to work towards a goal when it comes to fitness or running or whatever it is that you're training for. And you don't have to be a pro athlete to benefit from or need a training journal. That's a huge misconception. In Wild Souls, the online course that I created, there's a workout journal that helps you track things like how you're feeling, what inner season you're in as a woman, and some other things that aren't typically in a workout log. So for business, workouts, life, whatever it may be, I've actually started to write down wins from the month. At the end of each month, it's a time that I reflect and I go back to the previous month each time, actually, to remind myself and get that boost of confidence. And then I look back at the month that I just finished and look at what I felt like was a success during that month. And it's awesome to look at when it comes to the end of the year, too. So the truth is, positively reinforcing our successes allows us to get more enjoyment and satisfaction out of the process. So it's that idea of finding joy in the journey, and this is seriously one of the best ways to do it. So I want you to ask yourself, what's something you did recently that you're really proud of? And I don't want you to just think about it. I want you to actually send me a DM over on Instagram. I'm at Jenny Holbert. Or note it as part of your review for this podcast, and I will see it there. But seriously, do this, okay? I want to help you to take a step in this powerful process, and I'll be able to cheer you on too. So send me a DM over on Instagram at Jenny Holbert, or put it in the review that you leave for this podcast. And remember that the key to this practice is not just doing it once. You want to repeat it for best results. Make it a monthly habit, as I was sharing, to reflect on the previous month, and even make it a weekly habit as you're planning your week ahead to reflect on the week past. This is something that I want to implement even more that I'm practicing. So that's a major ingredient in my current recipe for confidence, reflecting on those past wins and successes. And if you want four other ways to build your confidence, I have an audio session for you on this in the upcoming edition of Wild Souls. So as you listen, you'll get other ways to remember how well you're really doing and how you can truly live your dreams. Plus, in this program, the Wild Souls Journal and the prompts I give you are a really helpful guide. So if you're interested in this conversation, you can go check out Wild Souls now at jennyholbert.com/wild. Hey, before you go, if you loved this episode, be sure to subscribe, review, and share it with someone. Thank you so much for listening, for showing up, and until we chat again, go live your one wild life.